Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today we're just gonna do some cozy writing in a cafe. I had to be somewhere in the morning and then I also had to be somewhere in the early afternoon, so I had a couple of hours to kill in town, so I thought I would go to a coffee shop and work on a book. Now, for those of you who have been following some of the projects I'm working on this channel, I just recently finished a draft of my fiction novel, which I am calling Project Caramel Latte. This is the first book in a series. I had already plotted out the sequel, which I'm using Project Pumpkin Spice Latte. Do you see a theme going here? But I've been putting off starting it. I wrote a scene and then kind of stopped, and then I rewrote that scene and then stopped. And today though felt like a really good time to just sit down and start really actually writing it. I felt a lot more inspired, and I think partly that's due to the weather. It's autumn here in Salisbury, and autumn is such a beautiful time of year, and it's a nice reminder of the fact that, you know, things go in cycles and things die, and you're in this space between life and death in autumn that is just such a wonderful, magical place to be in. And this book, Project Pumpkin Spice Latte, my sequel, the primary theme of the book is grief. And so while the book doesn't take place in autumn, it does have a lot of the same themes of loss and change and dealing with that loss and change. And so I think being in autumn is actually quite inspirational for some of the themes that I'm dealing with in the book. So I had written about 1,000 words before I got to a point where I realized I had kind of set myself up for some trouble. One of the main elements of this book is that the main character is going to be getting coded messages that she has to decipher, and then that leads her to a next big clue. And that sounded like a really fun idea to read and to partake in and try to figure out. And I hadn't considered the fact that that would mean I'd have to write a code and then actually code a message that can then be decoded. And I hadn't really thought about what codes I was going to be using in these. So I got to the point where she was supposed to find the first message and then realized, oh no, what does this message even look like? I have no idea. So I decided to put the computer away and sit down with a notebook and actually try to figure out all of the code materials. After I was done, I went for another little walk around Salisbury to clear my mind, get re-inspired by the environment, and sat down at another coffee shop. I had about an hour left before I had to be somewhere else, so I thought that I would sit down and do a little bit more work, but I was feeling a little drained on it, and I wasn't sure if my code worked yet. I was going to give it to a friend of mine to see if it was actually possible to be worked out, and so I decided to sit and instead do some brainstorming on topics for my next nonfiction book. That's what I did today while being around Salisbury, enjoying the landscape, and being inspired and doing a little bit of writing. Thank you for being with me today. Let me know what it was that you were working on while you watched this, if you were. If not, that's also fine. You can just be drinking tea and enjoying the atmosphere. Please do all of the YouTube things you hear people say all the time, the liking and the subscribing and all that kind of stuff. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!